to the Bastards Podcast.
Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of the Bot Squad Podcast. As always, I'm David, and this is
John.
What are we drinking today, man? Yes, Mackie. What are we drinking today?
I was okay with that.
Today we are drinking an Alaskan beer. Amber beer.
Amber beer?
Yeah, I've had this Alaskan beer, but not this one, not this amber one. Alaskan, they make a lot of different types, just like every other beer. Besides Budweiser, they only make Budweiser. And
now, is it bottled in Alaska? That's the real question.
You know what?
I have no idea.
No, I don't. It's just like, is like Ozarka spring water bottled in Ozarka or wherever the hell?
Yeah.
I guess not.
New York City?
You know that Ozarka water is bottled here in Houston?
Is it really?
I seen it.
Ah. All right. So, let's see here.
Never go anywhere without a bottle.
5.3 alcohol by volume. It popped mine open.
Oh,
here, take that one.
Thank you.
And, where's it from?
Alaska.
Is it really?
No.
No?
I don't know.
Alaskan Brewing Company, yeah.
Oh, it's from Alaska.
Mine smells like salmon.
Yep, tastes like Alaska.
It does? Mm-hmm.
Sure does.
And the reason why I picked this beer up, I was looking out, you know, oh, man. Okay, the guys were there to restock the beer and everything, and I was like, all right. And they were blocking on the fucking aisle, and I was like, all right. So I tried to get through. I couldn't, and it was like he was intentionally trying to do that.
Yeah.
And then, so I made my way through, like I had to bump the wines and everything, and I got through.
And get out of my way.
I noticed, I noticed when I looked, dude made an ugly face at me. You know, I was like, whatever. So I grabbed the other beers and everything. Well, I started looking around, and started poking around and everything, and I noticed another person was trying to get through, and he did the same thing to that person. So I intentionally got in his way,
again,
over there, you know, and started, like, you know, reaching over him and everything. And but anyways, I saw this, and what came to mind was David had posted up, I think it was a picture on Instagram yesterday. He may have attached it to different other things, from what I saw, it was on Instagram, and he was fed up that he is no longer going to shave his beard.
His face, right here.
So it's going to stay there forever and ever. Amen. And what caught my attention was this Alaskan beer, and I was thinking, you know, the beard.
I look like a fisherman, basically.
David looks like a fisherman.
Like an Alaskan fisherman.
Yeah. And so that's the story behind this beer.
And, yeah.
And I sang the song in my head, but I don't know the words to it.
Trust a golden fisherman.
And I bring it in, he sings that part. So it worked out good.
This beer's pretty good. It's not strong at all. Doesn't very has a very faint aftertaste.
Yeah.
It's really good. I like it.
It looks like that white water that's on the front of the... It tastes like that white water. All rapids and shit.
It's really good. Man. This is really good.
Is that a shrimp boat? They shrimp in Alaska?
Probably not. I don't think so. I think it's salmon. Anyway, so... Welcome to the fishing podcast.
Right.
We're going to go ahead and jump right in, and we're going to talk a little bit about Gene Wilder. Gene Wilder passed away this past week, and, you know, huge loss.
Yeah.
Huge loss to the film community. I mean, this guy, he's been in so many movies. Obviously, the big one that everybody knows and remembers is Willy Wonka. And, you know, I believe it was Hear No Evil, See No Evil?
Oh, yeah.
With Richard Pryor.
Richard Pryor.
Great movie. Stir Crazy. Another great movie. Man, he was just a guy, man, that, I mean, any film that he was in, I think he stopped acting in, like, 91. I want to say.
I thought he was already dead.
Or 92.
I thought he was dead already.
He had I think it was a complication from Alzheimer's disease that he died from.
Oh, shit.
Terrible, man. It's a big bummer. Because, you know, the biggest thing was Willy Wonka. Everybody loves Willy Wonka. So, you couldn't go on social media without people saying, you know, goodbye, Mr. Wonka, and they had, like, a post.
Or Golden Ticket.
Or everybody, yeah, Golden Ticket. Everybody was putting up their DVDs and stuff like that, or Blu-rays. So, I mean, you can tell by that it meant a lot, you know?
Yeah.
And it's a big hit. 2016 has sucked so far, as far as, like, you know, big celebrities, like, you know, dying.
Yeah.
Terrible, man. But, you know, I just want to say that I wrote a little something for this occasion as a tribute. And I just wanted to, you know, kind of put it out there on the podcast. John's looking at me weird because he doesn't know. But I put a little something together. And I wanted to say it right here. These words, I wrote these words down. They came from my heart.
Okay.
I'm serious. Okay? How do I say goodbye to what we had? The good times that made us laugh outweigh the bad. I thought we'd get to see forever, but forever has gone away. It's so hard to say goodbye to yesterday. I don't know where this road is going to lead. All I know is where we've been and what we've been through. If we get to see tomorrow, I hope it's worth all the wait. I mean, because it's so hard to say goodbye, of course, to yesterday. Woo! I'm kidding.
At first, I was like, oh, okay.
And I think Gene Wilder would appreciate, you know, a funny little anecdote to the end of it.
Was so. That your Shatner?
That was.
The Shat?
A little bit. But anyway, so we're going to go ahead and get on with the show. One thing that we're going to be talking about is American Horror Story. Okay? The last podcast, we were talking about it a little bit, and, you know, the whole conspiracy about what season 6 is about, uh-huh. Right? And, you know, we showed some clips.
Have you seen any new clips?
I saw a couple.
I saw one.
Yeah, I saw a couple of them. And there's all these hidden, or like these weird clips that are floating around one of the producers revealed that they're all like misdirections. Only one of them is legit, you know? And that, you know, I guess they're still putting out clips, and I still kind of feel like, well, it kind of sucks because, I mean, it's still a mystery. Nobody knows.
I think I know.
But one of the things that happened was that, you know, sometimes, like, websites or, like, I don't know, like, publications, like magazines,
uh-huh.
They kind of have to have this information ahead of time so that way they can make, like, list, like TV Guide, for instance.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, they have to have TV Guide. Anybody know what TV Guide is? No? But they you know, have to have this information ahead of time so they can make their listings and all that stuff, uh-huh. Right? Well, something came out a couple days ago, and it was kind of like, everybody was like, whoa, you just, like, gave it all away.
Really?
Yes. And it looks like that it's going to be titled American Horror Story, The Mist. Right? Now, obviously, The Mist, we know, is the movie, The Mist.
Stephen King,
yeah, the Stephen King written novella. Well, that's what it's called, the small story.
Novella,
what it's
yeah, novella.
And, you know, it was like, oh, man. I kind of feel like it kind of screwed everything up.
Okay.
In a way, the as far as the secretive goes.
It did, at least for me, because I thought it was something else.
And then to top it off, Rotten Tomatoes even has it on their site, too.
Hmm.
So, says American Horror Story, The Mist. You know? Now, along with that, I read something that apparently one of the ones that we were talking about specifically the last podcast
uh-huh.
is the legit one. And that's the one...
The creepy one?
With the creepy monster on the railroad tracks. And then I said, man, I really hope that they do that one, because uh-huh. that one's really cool. It looks creepy to me. So, apparently... That's the rumored, you know, thing right now.
Yeah.
The title seems like it's going to be legit. Now, as far as, you know, it being that creepy monster on the railroad tracks that's crawling along, that's still kind of like rumored.
Yeah,
still.
Yeah.
So, but all signs point to yes. And it's like right around the corner in September. So, I mean, we'll find out then. Okay, so what do you think about all this?
I'm happy with that.
You happy with that?
I've seen two. Besides the ones that we've seen on the last podcast here, I've seen two. I've seen one where there was a woman, she had her head bent over, and then there was bugs walking a line, and there was a slit in the back of her neck, and they were crawling into her spinal cord.
Oh, yeah, yeah, I saw that one.
And then I just recently...
Hey, what's up, Dan?
And I just recently seen another one while I was watching American
Ninja Warrior.
American Horror Story.
Ninja Warrior.
No. It was...
I'd watch that.
No. The one they got on right now is boring. No one can ever become a ninja. And the one I saw, it was a campsite, and you see this person, light, boom, you know, shines upon them. They raise up, and then they just go, like that.
Oh, yeah, the alien one?
Yeah. And then he takes them. And it kind of makes sense because, like...
That reminds me of the Blair Witch trailer.
Yeah, the tent going up.
Yeah, and then she's like, you know, so I'll screw this. And she grabs the stick thing. Mm-hmm. She breaks it, and the person's back breaks.
Oh.
And he's like, oh, my God. That movie looks freaking good.
It looks all right, man.
I'm actually excited for it.
But then it took a little turn, and then it kind of seemed like there was aliens involved.
What do you mean?
You didn't see the lighting when they were running? They're like lights, and they made that noise.
No,
It made the same sound that it made in season two of American Horror Story.
Oh, okay.
Remember when the what's his name, Kit or whatever?
Kit. Oh yeah.
Remember when he got abducted and everything?
Yeah.
It made the same noise and everything. I was like, come on.
Come on.
No.
Come on.
Come on. And well. Yeah, so I thought that's where they were going to go. Because a lot of the things were pointing to that. You know, even I think on the first season they talked a little bit about it. Second season. And I was like, oh, yeah, this is where it's going to go. And then, you know what? I'm happy. I like this. I like this so far.
Okay, so from the last time that we had the podcast, which was about two weeks ago, We try to do it every other week. Okay, from that last podcast, You hadn't watched American Horror Story.
No.
And I suggested to you guys, like, you should watch it, man, at least the first season. This dude texted me the other day. He's like, I hate you. I'm like, why? Like, I didn't even do nothing. He's like, because I've been watching American Horror Story. Now, tell the people out there on the intronets How many seasons you've gone through already.
2.5. But that was
2 weeks. That's crazy.
No, in 5 days.
Oh, in 5 days.
In 5 days. Shit. Because
it's even crazier.
In 2 days, we did one season, and then we already started dipping into the third, and then we took a little break, and then 2 days after that, we were done with season two, and then we were already getting into three. Witch bitch or whatever.
Witch bitch.
Yeah, the witches.
Oh, and coming.
The first episode was witch bitch, but yeah, then we started watching it. And then I'm supposed to go out of town, right?
Yeah.
I didn't talk to her about food or anything, nothing, like, you know, buy stuff at home. So when I go, she was like, well, what are we going to do when you leave? And we're going to be, you know, there's going to be that gap in between the show.
What do we do? And I mean, I don't even care about food. What do we do about American Horror Story?
I said, look, let's just finish this third season. And then when I get back, we'll continue.
Oh, my God.
It's good. It's weird that they use a lot of the same characters, actors, but...
It's an interesting thing, you know, that they use a lot of the same actors, so... but yeah, I mean, it's... Again, after season one, I feel like it kind of has its peaks and valleys.
Yeah.
Like, some are good, some are bad, or some start off good and then end bad, or vice versa. Some start off bad and end good.
Yeah.
So, what do you think about Coven so far? You said you're about halfway in.
It's good. I see where I guess I can more or less kind of figure out where it's going. You know, they're looking for like a supreme, I guess is what they call them, like a supreme witch, that which means that she has powers of every.
Now it would be funny if they just, like, you know, the whole season, they're like, we gotta find the supreme. You know, they go on this big journey, whatever, or shit starts happening, start killing people, and then at the end it's just a supreme pizza.
Damn.
They gotta find.
Did you know at Pizza Hut, they have like a regular Supreme, and then they got Super Supreme?
Super Supreme?
Yes.
What's the Super Supreme consist of?
I think they add like green olives and what else? It's like two ingredients.
That's it?
Oh, and no, it has chicken instead of I'm not lying.
Instead of the sausage or something?
Something like that, yeah. I didn't know that.
Okay, when I hear the word Super Supreme, I would automatically think double everything.
Double everything and like
or triple everything.
The crust and everything.
Yeah, fucking make a big old pile
of topping. Well, how would it bake?
I did that one time and I screwed it up totally.
You know what I muffed up last week? I saw this little thing like they were making like little strombolis, these little bitty, you know.
Yeah.
Where they put like they put pepperoni down with like a stick of cheese. And then they put a little marinara in and they folded them up and they kind of look like
just a little bit of marinara,
just
a little bit,
And then they look like
it looked like you, it looks like you're rolling a joint.
All right,
just a little bit of marinara.
Well, they look like breadsticks, and then you know you have your marinara and you dip it in and eat it, right? Man, I destroyed that, man. I put too much marinara. They couldn't close. They wouldn't stay. So they just look like little bitty rectangular pizzas and stuff.
So, all right. So on the Twitch stream, Blu-ray Dan says, I need to get on that. So I haven't seen one episode of that show yet. I always hear good things. Yeah, I mean, good. The first season is the best.
It comes out swinging, man.
Yeah, that's one of the best, man. Like I said earlier, you know, other than that, it kind of has its peaks and valleys.
Mm-hmm.
I think the second season started off really good.
Yeah.
And it ended really strange.
Weird, yeah.
Third season is good, too.
You know, the first season?
The only one that I haven't caught up on in Oz is the most recent one, Hotel. So I need to go back and watch that.
I'm going to watch all of them. Yeah. But like, okay, like the first season was really, really good, man. I think we were like two episodes left into it. I remember thinking in the middle of it, I was like, fuck, it's going to end.
Fuck.
Because the next season, it's a totally different story and everything. So I was like, man. And it's going to get boring, you know? And it's going to be weird. Cause
apparently, the hotel season, this last one, has ties to the first season.
Ah.
So, and then apparently, from what I hear rumored, just like we said on the last podcast, the sixth season is supposed to tie everything together. How? I don't know.
I've been thinking about just trying to, you know, keep that in mind while I watch them all and everything. Yeah. I somehow or another, some of these people have to be related. Something like that.
Yeah.
It has to be.
Some way,
yeah.
And they all look the same.
Stupid.
Doppelganger on top of doppelganger on top of doppelganger.
You know, it's just alternate dimensions or something. Yeah. You know?
Some sliders.
I watched that Interstellar.
Bring up Sliders. I'm sorry.
You always have a chance. You're going to bring up Sliders, man. Hey, you know what?
Just like Sliders. Yeah, this medical drama, man, it's so good. Just like Sliders, right?
Yeah.
What were you saying? I'm sorry.
I watched Interstellar last night.
What'd you think?
It was good.
I thought it was great.
I thought it was really good. I fell asleep a couple times.
I could understand that. Especially if you have to watch it at the right time.
I watch it at night.
Yeah, if you watch it too late, you're gonna doze off.
But I watched the hell out of it. My kids, they were just like, I made them stay up. It was like 2 a.m. And they were like,
you will stay up with me.
You're like,
Dad, I'm sleepy.
Go, what was it about? And I was like, you don't
shut your mouth.
You don't get it. Go to your room.
You get all mad at them. You're grounded. For not getting a movie that's just like way above you.
I told my daughter, I was like, you'll watch this movie again one day and then you're going to be like, oh.
All right, well, so we're going to move on from American Horror Story and we're going to talk about a clip that just popped up on the internet earlier this week. No explanation. I saw it like literally, I think it was like 8 a.m., dude. And I'm like, I thought somebody like just posted a clip, like a...
Man, hold up.
Like a cosplay clip or something.
How are you always coming across stuff like this? Like David, like he showed me these videos like, nobody has any explanation where it came from.
Well,
he goes, I'm not going to say too much. I'm going to watch it.
I'm not going to say too much, okay?
You just watch it and just tell me what you
think. That's not the important thing.
And he showed me this one that was this person laying down on the face down on the floor.
Oh, that was just weird.
And
That's something. You know what? I'm gonna actually next podcast. I'm gonna put that as the intro. Yeah. As the intro. Countdown.
I'm sure you can put a bunch of those damn videos up.
Yeah.
I don't know, but he showed me the video and it's like weird and
it's so strange. But anyway, this clip though. No, it's not that weird. All it was the clip. I saw it 8 a.m. I'm like, what is this? And
weird.
You know, it was Deathstroke.
Oh.
I'm like, why are you saying it's weird? It was Deathstroke. And I was like, okay, is somebody cosplaying as Deathstroke or something? Because it looked shaky.
Yeah.
And then I look up at the who posted it. It said Ben Affleck. I'm like, whoa, what? Hold on. So I looked at it, and it was just one of those, like, I couldn't explain. I didn't know how to feel right at that moment. Yeah. I'm like, what? Deathstroke? And here's the clip. So you can watch it. I mean, it's just, it's shaky. He's, coming in off of, like, an airplane hangar and kind of just looks around. There's no sound to it at all. And it's shot from a monitor, like, from a monitor on set. So it's the only thing that they're filming right now is they're filming Justice League, right now.
Yeah.
But I was also thinking at that moment, I was like, well, is it just test footage for the Batman movie?
Yeah.
I didn't want to make any, speculation. I didn't want to say, oh my God, he's going to be in Justice League. Or, oh, he's going to be in Batman. But as soon as I saw it and I posted it up on the Facebook pages and stuff, I shared it. And then I just start seeing all these headlines. He's going to be in Justice League. He's going to be in the Batman movie.
I saw that too.
I'm like, y'all don't know for sure. But the rumor right now, I like to, always say if it's a rumor or not, because nobody knows for sure until we see the movie. The rumor right now is that he's going to be doing a cameo appearance in the Justice League movie.
Okay.
And then he'll full on be in the Batman solo movie. That sounds more legit, so I feel like.
Batman's going to kill him because Batman almost destroyed Superman. Right?
Yeah.
He's going to kill him. He's going to wear the same suit
and beat him up. Deathstroke is a watered-down version of Deadpool. So he does... I mean, he's killable, but he's impervious to a lot. Like, he can take a lot of damage.
Yeah, he's almost like Batman.
Yeah.
Almost.
Yeah.
They're both rich. They
almost. So I think it's a cool... it's a cool villain to have. To have go toe-to-toe with Batman, because they're, like you said, they're very similar.
Yeah.
I don't know if the character is interesting enough, though, to me.
Thank you. Because when I saw it, and when I saw a little headline saying, leaked video or whatever, or what it says, it says something about leaked video character coming out in Justice League movie. And I'm looking at it, and I'm thinking, oh, cool, right?
Yeah.
And then it shows him, and I was like,
yeah.
Can you put Clayface in there?
I mean, I like him. Don't get me wrong.
Yeah,
there's times where he's really cool.
Yeah.
But I don't know if I could buy him being a villain of an entire movie. You know what I mean?
Did you beat the last Batman game?
Yes, I did.
You did?
Yeah.
All right.
That whole ending part.
Yes.
He just stayed in a tank the whole time.
Well, yeah.
And I was disappointed in that.
Well, see, like, he had left, right? And, like, in the middle of the game, he was gone, right? You didn't see Deathstroke anymore. And then you beat the main guy, and then all of a sudden he takes over again. And he's the last one. He's in the tank. You destroy the tank. And I was like, I really would have done good without Deathstroke at the end. You know what I mean? I would have been fine when everything else was done. But then they just threw him in there. Oh, yeah, because we didn't have any more story, so... You know what I mean?
Like, well, just throw him in there.
I don't know, man.
I think the game could have done without him, though. Now, the part that I did like was, well, the part that frustrated me but was really cool was the fight part in Arkham Origins versus Deathstroke. I thought that was really cool. And come to find out, it's choreographed by the director that directed Deadpool.
What?
Yeah. Huh. So that kind of shows it right there.
No wonder it was cool.
Dan here says, I'm glad we'll be getting a different villain for once. Now, I agree with that. I mean, it's something that, you wouldn't expect. Yeah. Nobody would expect, really.
Right now, he's in the limelight, man.
He's just,
and you know what? His outfit, what it reminds me of, if you go and you look at the the Play Arts figures.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
He looks like that figure. The color and everything, he kind of resembles it, but he's real bulky, man.
Yeah,
he's
just, honestly, like Cyrax. The way it looks like, it kind of does look like Cyrax with the little, uh-huh, you know, ponytail thing. But, honestly, it's, I think the costume needs a little bit of work.
Yeah.
Now, maybe they use that costume for, you know, the little cameo in Justice League, if that's what they're going to do, and then they upgrade it, you know, a certain way in the Batman movie.
Yeah.
Because, to me, honestly, when I saw it, I just thought cosplay.
Yeah.
I thought somebody just, threw on a Deathstroke costume.
So, they haven't announced who's going to be Deathstroke, right?
Or no. There's speculation, again. All these things, people, rumors, things that are going on. They did say that Joe Manganiello.
And Joni.
No. Manganiello, the guy from True Blood and Magic Mike and all that other stuff.
Why did you guys say that? He was in Pee-wee.
Oh, yeah, he was in Pee-wee. Yeah. I didn't watch it, but I knew he was in Pee-wee.
Man, it's a funny movie, man.
But, yeah, so there's rumor that people were like, you know, oh, well, he's in London right now. He went to London recently. They're filming Justice League in London. He just followed Zack Snyder on Twitter, you know. So people are just like, you know, grabbing little things. It's possible. I think he would make a great Deathstroke, though.
Think so?
Yeah, I think he'll gray his hair up just a little bit more, and that's it. Throw an eye patch on him.
Because him and Ben Affleck kind of look alike.
Kind of, I guess.
Well, I mean, if you look at Deathstroke, the character himself,
the dude's a big guy. Yeah,
big dude, older guy.
Yeah,
like Snake.
I remember a while back older they were Snake. Talking about like Kevin Nash. Possibly,
I heard about
you know, being a Deathstroke. Who else? There was somebody else, man. I can't remember recently. I don't know. But like, I gave up, whatever.
The movie with the... He was the colonel in that movie with the Avatar.
No, that guy... And actually, I'm glad you brought that up because I was going to bring that up next. Was that guy, he still wants to be Cable.
Oh, that's what it was, Cable. Okay.
He still wants to be Cable. Now, I saw Don't Breathe recently.
He's in it.
Yeah, he's the main guy in
it.
And
was it any good?
It was great.
Man, I knew it.
It was so great. I hadn't seen a movie like that in a long time that was like that had that tension to it the entire time. Now, a part of it did feel like because it is directed by the guy that did the Evil Dead remake.
Okay.
So you can see certain like directorial style.
Yeah, the style. In it.
Like the same filming style, certain jump scares and stuff like that. But they were good.
Yeah.
It wasn't a jump scare just to you know scare somebody.
Yeah.
It was, you know, done purposefully. It was
demanded.
Yeah. I mean, the scene demanded it. It did. You know, you picked a nice word there. You're like, eh? But yeah, no, it was a great movie though. The entire film was just like edge of your seat, like oh my god.
See, that's what I heard.
Yeah, and then it gets weird at the end, but a good kind of weird.
Okay,
but still weird.
I heard something on the radio. I'm gonna say this. All right, it is our local radio station. There's a chick on there. She said something on there. And it kind of, like, ruined the movie for me a little bit. I don't know if you caught what she said last time.
No.
About the Batman, the Suicide Squad movie.
No.
She gave away an ending to it and people got
Why
pissed.
Why do people do that?
I don't know.
Why does she do that?
Well, I don't think she just...
Call her out.
She just said it.
Call her out.
Oh, Dinah?
See, Dinah?
Dinah.
Come on, Dinah.
Well, she said... I haven't seen Suicide Squad, so spoiler alert. She mentioned, oh, yeah, you know, at the end of the movie, Joker and Harley, they get away and they do blah, blah. And I was like, hey, man, it blew up. I don't know. You didn't hear that?
No.
No. Man, dude, the manager ended up walking into their session, I guess. Whatever.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and he was like, hey, you know, why am I getting all these emails? And she was like, I know, I'll see you after. He goes like, yeah, you need to come to my office after.
What? Are you serious? Like, during the broadcast?
During the broadcast, yeah.
Whoa.
But it was all giggles and everything. But I'm sure he told her, hey, you need to chill. So check this out. The following week. So she says, movie review. They have a movie review Monday. And so she's like, yeah, this movie's coming out. And then this Don't Breathe movie comes out. She's like... She says, it's a real good movie. She says, I can't wait to see it. It's when these people, they go into a house and they rob it and everything. They find out he's a... I already know, so I'm just going to say spoiler.
Yeah.
He's a serial killer, and then it gets all weird. And I didn't know that! I was like...
Well, okay. She kind of got it wrong. He's not a serial killer.
Okay.
But he is... not a good guy.
Okay,
you know,
I didn't know that. I just figured, like they said, you know. Yeah. I figured, you know, okay, the dude was doing a little excessive, you know, punishment.
Yeah,
because you're in my job.
Well, yeah,
you know, but when she said that,
you can kind of gauge that from the trailers, more or less, you know. But yeah, when you watch it, your thought process flips like completely.
It reminded me of like People Under the Stairs.
Kind of.
Like how they couldn't get out of the damn house.
Yeah, it like, kind of seems that way.
How can you not get out of a house? You know?
But that movie is great. Uh-huh. I don't have any graphics for that because it just kind of happened right here. Mm. But great movie. That guy, speaking of that guy, like we were talking about, boom, boom, boom. That guy, though, he still wants to be Cable. And I don't see it.
I do, man.
Look, leave him alone. Okay, maybe his facial features and his head and all that stuff. And the dude... The dude legitimately, he looks built.
Big.
He looks built for an older guy at that. In that Don't Breathe, you see it.
Really?
Like, he's stacked, dude. Like, he looks big. But he's not Cable big. He's not Cable big. I don't know if you strap gun holsters and shoulder pads and everything on him. I don't know if that's even going to make a difference. It might make him look silly.
Is he short?
No, it doesn't seem like he's short. Now the other person that they were rumored to be, you know, I guess going after for the Cable role as well, was the coach from Friday Night Lights. Ooh. That I really don't see.
Wait, Friday Night Lights the movie or the show?
The show.
I've never seen
the show. But I believe his name is Kyle Chandler, I think it is. And it's not Kyle Reese, John. It's not Kyle Reese, okay. Enough of the Terminator. That franchise is over.
It makes sense, dude. It's the future. Cable is from the future.
But, you know, they're trying to get that guy, the coach from Friday Night Lights. And, again, I don't see it either because the guy's like a real clean-cut country guy, you know?
Man, dude,
and I don't see it.
Man.
They need to get somebody like Kevin Nash or something. That dude's big, you know?
Yeah, he is.
And he's like, I think he just turned 60.
Damn.
And he's freaking huge.
Did you hear about them owning a baseball team? The NWO bought a baseball team?
No, are you serious?
Scott Hall, Kevin Nash, and X-Pac are managers and owners of a baseball team.
And since when? What baseball team?
I don't know. I forget. But I don't know if they're called NWO, but they were... Those three refer themselves
to the Portland Two Sweets.
Two Sweets. But yeah, they own.
new world order.
But they recently just bought a team. Look, they were bagging on them on the radio.
They got the money for it.
If they're wrestlers, they're wrestlers. It doesn't mean that like their life ended right there. Like that's all they know is how to wrestle.
It's a business decision.
Yeah,
you know.
You know, I'm sure...
It's weird.
Yeah.
It's weird to hear, but, yeah. For life.
It's like that. You barely pick up that thumb from
That's
the
Scott L. Steiner. Even if Scott Steiner was, like, so jacked, full of steroids, his thumb was, like, had a six-pack on it. Yeah, couldn't even move.
It wouldn't even... You would just do that.
But, yeah, no. I mean, more power to him. It's a business thing, so... That's cool.
But Kevin Nash would fit.
I think so. Yeah.
I mean, think of when he was the Sailor and the Punisher.
Yeah.
You know?
Big dude.
Big motherfucker.
Speaking of the NWO. See how I segue there?
Yeah.
I saw a clip recently of X-Pac where he tried to do the Bronco Buster to the turnbuckle and he tore his butthole.
What?
Like, he was talking about it. And this was, I want to say it was like Mexico or something. Like, he was hauling ass. He jumped way before where he should have jumped. And when he jumped, the guy moved out of the way, as you know, probably scripted or whatever. Yeah. And the way he fell, here's a turnbuckle. He hit the turnbuckle and slid. And yet he has padding or cushion, you know, there. But it hit so hard that he tore himself a new one, basically.
Man, how does that happen?
And you just see him grabbing his butt like, oh. He's like jumping up and down. And he, throughout the entire time, he's just holding his butt, you know? And, okay, I'm like, he said, and he talked about it. He was like, yeah, he's like, it happened. It was an accident. And it hurt so bad. I had to go get surgery.
Damn.
They had to stitch him up, basically. And he had to wear adult diapers for about 3 months.
Yeah, I can imagine you just shitting on him.
So I'm like, man, give me a laxative for 3 months.
Oh, you just push it in, the laxative ones? What are those called? Those,
No, I don't want to talk about it no more.
The pink ones?
No. moving on, okay. Apparently, I'm sorry, hold on. Apparently, Dwayne The Rock Johnson is rebooting Jumanji. No, don't talk about suppository.
I was thinking,
he's rebooting Jumanji The Rock.
Oh, yeah.
All right?
Wow.
Now, exactly. Now, okay, now we can go, you know, on forever why they shouldn't. But the truth is, they are. We can't fight it no more. You know? You can't put out petitions and all this. It's happening. It is.
The Rock, he's just making all these remakes or what?
I think he's just doing. He's just trying to capitalize on, you know, maybe old properties or whatever. And for the most part, The Rock has been very successful.
Man, David, be quiet.
He has.
You just, all that you just said right there was just like, look, man, like, just, you know what? He's just like capitalizing on our old stuff, and you just gotta give him a try.
No. I'm not at all saying that this is gonna be good.
Hold on.
I'm saying the proof is in the box office. The dude, like, he kills it every time.
No.
Whether I like it or not.
Man,
you know,
I remember
people go see The Rock.
No, they don't. Well, now they do.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying now.
But his other movies.
Oh yeah, no, his first one was shit.
Yeah, I remember. You were telling me the same little thing. You said, man, you know what, man? It's gonna be great and everything. He's coming out with this new movie. He goes, and if he doesn't do anything on this one, it's gonna be it for him. And then a Walking Tall movie, it actually worked out.
That one was a great one.
That,
I really liked that.
I remember when you told me, yeah, he goes, if he doesn't do good in this one, it's over.
Yeah.
And then he did. And then he came back and he made that Be Cool, and he was gay in that movie. That was even better, man.
Yeah, man. He was really good in Be Cool. That's still one of my favorite movies.
That was a really good movie.
But yeah, so he's rebooting Jumanji. And the thing that struck me as weird, though, was that they had already announced the cast. Right?
Already?
Yeah. That's how far along they've already been, like, you know, fast-tracking it.
Uh-huh.
This dude, he plans movie after movie after movie. Like, he don't stop. Like, I don't know. I mean, I don't think he's ever taken a vacation.
Yeah.
Or something. But the cast of Jumanji is Kevin Hart, Jack Black, Karen Gilliam, Dwayne The Rock Johnson, obviously, and Nick Jonas.
Why?
I don't know. That's what strikes me as weird. Now, the Kevin Hart, okay, honestly, when Kevin Hart first, like, when Kevin Hart first came out,
uh-huh,
I didn't like him. Like, I really did not like him.
I still don't like him.
He's okay.
No.
I think he's okay. He was great in Central Intelligence. Him and The Rock were perfect.
That's that, the recent one, right?
Yeah.
I wanted to watch that movie.
They were great in that movie. It was a fun movie. I laughed the entire time.
Mm-hmm.
Jack Black, I don't know, unless maybe he plays the bad guy. I think that'd be kind of cool.
The
Jack
Hunter?
Black. Yeah. Something like that.
I see it.
Karen Gillian, she played Nebula in Guardians of the Galaxy. She was on Doctor Who as well. I think maybe she's going to play the love interest. I don't know. And Nick Jonas.
He's going to play the love interest.
Nick Jonas is the big question mark. Like, is he just going to be like the little sidekick? That they, you know.
You're going to turn his ass.
He's the monkey guy.
He's the monkey.
He kind of looks like a monkey already. So he might be the monkey guy. Now, I don't know if they're going to go... Now, from what I'm hearing, that it's not going to be a complete remake. You know, it's more going to be like, I guess, kind of like a sequel.
Uh-huh.
So they're still going to acknowledge the stuff that happened with Robin Williams and stuff, which is good.
Yeah.
You know, I'm glad that they're going to at least keep that, you know, in mind. And because I think if they didn't and they try to remake the whole thing, people would be pissed.
Yeah.
Everybody loves Robin Williams. I mean, come on.
You know? And that movie actually did pretty good.
It was good. It's, to me, I think it still kind of holds up.
When you watch it now, it looks like crap, but I mean...
You think so? Yeah, I think it still kind of holds up. Does. Like the stampede parts and stuff like that.
How would you react to that? The part in the attic?
Screw you.
In the attic?
Screw you. No, I knew you were going to bring that up.
If you got stuck in, on the ground and the face was like... Your face was like this on the ground.
I'd cry so bad.
And the spiders were getting...
I would cry. I would legit cry so bad. If
I
had
to defend you, I would let them get like real close to you.
You're an asshole. I'm trying not to cuss, but you're an asshole.
I'd be like, I got it. Damn it, it's out of my hands, man.
I hate you. But yeah, I'm sure they're going to have something like that again. I mean, you can't have Jumanji and like... animals and all this stuff, creatures, mm-hmm. without spiders. Spiders always creep me out no matter what. I still, to this day, have not seen Arachnophobia in about 20 years or so.
That's with Jeff Daniels, right?
Yeah.
And
John Goodman.
John Goodman, yeah.
Yeah. I still have not seen that movie in about 20 years. Something like that.
when I saw that movie, I didn't want to watch it. But when I watched it, I was like, it's pretty cool, you know.
And Arachnophobia?
Then, yeah. And it wasn't all that great. And then I found myself, when I watch it, like every now and then... Like, it doesn't bother me. I'll watch it.
Hell no. Of course it don't bother you.
You remember that part? Have you ever seen it?
Yeah.
You remember that part where he's looking up in that chute?
And then it comes rushing down? or where the ending part where all the spiders are coming out of everywhere in the house?
Yeah.
And he's walking through and he goes, like the spider coming down on his face. That is terrifying to me, man. Oh, my God.
Last night when we were watching Interstellar, my daughter was laying down on the ground watching TV. And she was, like, covered up. All you could see was just her face on her on the blanket. And she stood, boom, she jumped straight up and took that blanket off and got into her little scared position.
She jumped out and left the blanket there, and it still was, like,
well, yeah, it was still and she was, someone was crawling on me. I was like, baby, look, it probably could have been one of your hair, you know. It happens, you know, when a hair, you know.
It's happened to me before.
Your wife has long hair.
Where, like a hair will come off of my hair, uh-huh. my head, and it'll, like, brush against my face. I'm like, oh, yeah.
well, I was telling her, and she's like, no, I know what it was. And I don't know how my son saw this, but he's, like, on the other side of the room, and in the carpet, it was a spider. And it was the same color as the carpet.
Really?
And he goes, there it is. And I'm like, where? And I'm looking at, I couldn't see it, but it was a big old brown spider.
It's right there.
Liar.
You scared my guard.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did. No, I didn't.
Prove it.
It's right there.
That's a long ass scratch. But anyway, it was a big, it was like a quarter sized, like light brown, whatever the hell, spider.
Yeah.
And I had to kill it. I turned all cool and stuff.
You turned all like hero mode. See, okay, when it comes down to it, and like say any, you know, my kids, my wife, whatever.
No,
I'm serious.
I don't believe it.
If it comes down to it and I have to kill, I will. But see, I'll kill it, but I'll kill it with so much like fury and force that it's not going to be alive after I get the...
You don't want to have to swing twice.
Yeah, exactly. I swing like I mean it, and that's it.
Like it's demanded.
Yeah. And then after the fact, when, you know, I know it's dead, and then I calm down, and I'm like... I'm like... Then that's when I revert back. So you could almost call me like a transformer. So anyway, moral of the story, I hate spiders. I'm going to go ahead and move on to Fear the Walking Dead. The new episode just passed this past Sunday. I don't know, have you caught up to it?
No, I haven't.
I
know they showed like all the episodes leading up to this.
Yeah, it was a good episode, uh-huh. but it kind of infuriated me.
Are you up to date on it?
Yes.
Oh, you are?
Okay. It kind of infuriated me. We'll just talk about it a little bit since you haven't seen it.
I don't care. Go ahead, man.
You know, they kind of got to this part. They're still traveling, and they kind of got to this part. No spoilers. I got to give one. I'm sorry. Just one little one. But this part, though, was kind of in the trailers. Uh-huh. So it's not too spoilery.
Uh-huh.
There was a part, if you want to mute it, you can, I guess, for the next 5 minutes, and then I can go like this or something whenever we're over.
He's going to forget.
So there's a part that they're traveling still, And they arrive at that hotel, that big hotel on, by the beach. They showed in the in the Comic-Con trailer. And that's when I was like, okay, it reminds me a lot of Dead Island.
Yes.
You know? And it really did. Like, the whole, that whole moment, they walked through the hotel, and they broke apart a little bit, and some of them were opening up doors to the rooms and stuff like that. And some of the rooms were locked because there was people still in there. You know? And that felt so much, like it was pulled so much from Dead Island. It was a cool sequence. I liked that whole part.
Yeah.
But the thing that infuriated me the most was Strand, the black dude.
The
black dude.
Yeah.
And the main girl. I forget her name. Always, you know, flies away from my head. But they were down in the lobby, and they got to the bar, and they started drinking.
Oh.
And it's like, I would not drink during the apocalypse. I would not drink at all during the apocalypse.
Who said in the apocalypse?
I would be so scared to drink during the apocalypse because you don't know what's going to happen from moment to moment.
Man, I'll chug a lug, man.
Now, okay.
This
is what I said. I was telling Monica, I was like, okay, maybe I would have a drink or two. You know, I'd catch a little buzz. I would not get wasted.
No, I don't think I'd do that. Unless I was, like, secured.
Yeah, because, again, it's moment to moment. You don't know what's going to happen. It's unpredictable. Well, they decided to keep drinking. And they got so hammered, you know, to the point where they didn't inspect the whole hotel. They don't know.
Yeah.
And they kept drinking, and they're like, oh, I'm playing the piano. Ding, 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 ding. And they're being stupid, throwing bottles everywhere. And I'm like, oh, I already know what's happening. I know what's going to happen. They got the attention of the infected. And they started hoarding the hotel, you know, and then... Because of all the piano playing, it echoed through the hotel, which is completely quiet. So it would make sense. It would echo at least a bit. The people that were in the rooms were following the sound to the balconies, and they were dropping off of the balconies. Like, all the zombies were falling off of the hotel. And they kept, you know...
Was this like
the ones that lived... Got up and...
Was this like a centered, where it was like an open middle?
It was kind of, made like a V.
Okay.
So like the lobby was over here kind of thing, and the rest of the hotels were like this.
Uh-huh.
They go up, and so they were falling down into the courtyard area.
Uh-huh.
And the ones that did survive and the ones that were coming out from another building were just like swarming the place. I'm like, y'all are fucking stupid, man. Y'all are dumb.
And hammered.
Yeah. I'm like... You know, I was like, you know what? This will teach y'all, man. It's going to teach y'all a lesson.
Somebody's going to die.
I was so mad, though, because that was the one thing infuriated me about that part. I'm like, it's kind of common sense. Don't get hammered during something like this, you know? But the rest of the episode was really great. We're done. So the rest of the episode was really good, though.
You know how they mentioned that somebody or maybe a couple of the people from this season of this version of the Fear of the Walking Dead or whatever?
Yeah.
That they said that, like, some of these main people were going to, at least somehow or another way down the line, are supposed to meet up with, like, Rick and the other group.
Yeah, I don't know if that's the case anymore.
Well, hold on.
Oh, go ahead. Keep going.
What if, and this is what I was thinking, what if the guy, the Johnny Depp look dude, what if, since he's already getting real wise to covering himself in blood and everything, what if he's, like, one of, like, the creators of the Whisperers?
What if he's the young Negan?
No.
No, I'm kidding. That's actually a pretty good... pretty good guess.
Or like, right now, prediction. He's good and cool, but later on, he's just like...
There was also a rumor going around that the lady or the woman in the show could possibly be Alpha in the comics. Alpha in the comics is like the lead Whisperer.
They referred her as that during one of the...
I think they called her an alpha leader or something like that. So that's why I think that's why people were speculating. I don't think that's the case, though. But they also did... It was... I don't want to say, but it was revealed where she came from.
Mm-hmm.
So people were also speculating that, well, maybe she's related to somebody from the main show,
mm-hmm.
you know, at some point. It could, I mean, again, it could possibly be maybe down the line. I don't think right now they're going to try to plan for something like that. I think they want them to stand as two different shows for now. Because then they're going to, as soon as somebody connects it together, then they'll be like, whoa, when's the crossover? When's the crossover? When's we're going to see these people all over there?
Yeah.
I would say the only way that's going to happen is if Fear the Walking Dead gets canceled. No, for real. That's the only way it would make sense. You know, because the shows are 6 weeks apart.
Yeah.
You know, as far as, you know, starting from the beginning, if you both start them at season one, they're both six weeks apart. So there would be no reason for them, and they're at separate points in the U.S., so there'd be no reason for them to meet up at all. Now, if Fear the Walking Dead got canceled, and maybe give it like a season or so, you know, in between, like for the Walking Dead to continue on a season, maybe you could introduce a character or two and be like, I made it all the way from da 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 or whatever, you know?
Wearing this blood.
Wearing this blood. So, I mean, that would be, I think, the only way that would make sense. Now, The Walking Dead, The Walking Dead is getting to a point where they're not exactly catching up to the comics, but they're pretty close.
Yeah.
So it's kind of concerning a lot of people. Like, how are you going to keep this up? You know, and it's there's a point where after the whole Negan thing happens in the comics, they fast forward, like, about a year in the comics. Like, between issues,
yeah,
they fast forward a year. They don't show you what happened. So what people are thinking is that after this, they're going to do a whole original season.
Wow. Makeup shit?
To kind of fill that 1 year gap that happened in the comics. You know what I mean?
And then lead up to it again?
In a way, it's kind of cool because it gives them the freedom to experiment. You know, a little bit.
Man, I don't know.
And then and then keep following the comics after that.
Man, hold up.
Now, I'm interested... Get out of here. I'm interested to see if they're going to end up making Rick the way he looks in the comics.
All fucked up and everything.
He's like, he's bald.
Yeah, and he's like, cutoff hand and everything.
I still don't think they're going to do the cutoff hand, though.
Man, come on.
Because they've already said it themselves, it's too expensive to have a cutoff hand in every scene. Mm. Like CG and all that stuff.
Like, they're not making enough money.
Now, the guy that Andrew Lincoln plays Rick, he wants it. He'd been asking for the hand to get chopped off forever. But Robert Kirkman had come out and said, he's like, I regret chopping off Rick's hand in the comics because it handicapped him so much. Like, you know, it prevented him from doing certain things.
Yeah.
You know?
Like, what's his name?
And he's like, and it kind of, it wrote him into a corner. Like, he had to, like, figure out, okay, I have to remember that he doesn't have a hand kind of thing. So I don't think he wants to do that again. I think what Robert Kirkman is trying to do is fix the things that he felt like he messed up in the comic on the show.
Man, that's bullshit.
Including people dying and stuff like that. You know what I mean? So, I mean, we'll see how it goes as far as if they're actually going to do that or full, like, original season or not. I think it would be smart to do that because you're going to lengthen the show even longer. You know what I mean? But the one thing that I did want to talk about is I do have the newest season of The Walking Dead. And they do include the uncensored Negan speech at the end. And it was pretty awesome. Wow. I have to say. I mean, I went into it thinking, I was like, it's just a bunch of F words, you know, whatever. He's just going to drop F bombs like crazy. And he did, but it felt a lot
better. Damn.
You know what I mean? It just felt like it was more intense. Like, oh, man, he meant it. Like, he meant this, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And from the count that I took, I think it was like 24.
Damn.
Yeah, and within like a 10-minute span, dude.
Damn.
And still, I rewatched the whole season again, just kind of, you know, refresh myself. And, oh, man, it was a really good season. I really liked it a lot. That whole ending with Negan when he dropped the bat at the end. You just hear like the squishing sound of somebody at the end. Oh, man, you can't help but just cringe every time. It was like six times or okay. something like that.
You know what? I heard something. I didn't get to get into it the last time we talked about it. But they said that there was like a a German or a Russian, not trailer, but like a little trailer that, that was on TV or whatever got released.
Fuffy Butt says, "We need a designated zombie killer."
Oh, from
drinking, yeah. Anyway, go ahead. Fuffy Butt. That's a funny name.
He said that basically what you predicted, that in that episode or that, that trailer that they showed, that not only one person is going to take it, that what's his name is going to get it too.
Abraham. And Glenn.
They show somebody getting whacked and Abraham making a move, and then that's where the because everybody's expecting Glenn to be getting.
Yeah. I mean, that's the obvious answer.
And then when it happens again, like, well, that second murder, that there's going to be two. So two are going to die. And when then that's where you see Abraham, and he gets it. And then that's where everybody's going to be, oh, my God, I didn't know. But he said that, yeah, it was in the trailer. He was like, he saw a piece of it. And I was like, man, I go, did you not watch our podcast? Because David was talking about that, you know.
Spoiler.
Well, yeah, that's... I don't know. Lately, I'm going to toot David's horn.
Boop, boop, boop.
Yeah, because lately, the things that he's been saying and everything, they have been coming to pass.
Yeah. I mean, the thing is, okay, a lot of people just, like, they throw out rumors because they're, oh, what if this? What if it? You have to kind of like think about it and, you know, analyze the situation. What would make more sense as a writer?
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Shock.
Yeah. What do you think the writers would do, you know, to shock people?
When's the new season? Is it in October?
October 29th. No, 25th, I think, is the new season of The Walking Dead. Yeah. So, yeah, you have to think about it as a writer and also and think about, okay, well, what would I do if I was in this situation to change things around to shock people to shock people to make them not expect it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So yeah, I mean it's not just like blindly, oh, I think this is gonna happen because whatever. It you kind of have to think about it a little bit.
I see it, man. I see it big time.
Yeah. I think this next season of The Walking Dead is probably. I keep saying this that it's gonna be one of the best. You know, but it progressively gets better and better. You know what I mean?
Yeah. What was it? Two seasons ago, I think it was kind of bland. But then this last season, it was
yeah.
And then I think they're headed in the right direction.
See, but and every season, people were like, oh, well, it sucks because you know there was this slowdown period. Well, you kind of have to have those filler episodes a little bit.
Action all the fucking time. Yeah. This isn't expendable.
This isn't Jean-Claude Van Damme or nothing.
No.
So, yeah, I mean, you kind of have to have those filler episodes where it slows everything down a little bit, you know, and gives people a break.
People don't want that, but still, you have to. If not, man, we would go through this damn thing in two seasons.
That's why, honestly, you know, even from the very beginning, when people were, like, dropping off with season two, when they were at the farm, because they're like, oh, it's so boring. They're just at the farm. I'm like, I kept defending it the whole time. Yeah. I'm like, you have to have these story moments, you know?
That was good. That was good in season.
Yeah. It's those story moments that make the characters go forward. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah. The only episodes that I can't watch now, and I've said it before, is the ones with the governor. Wherever, when the governor's like walking by his lonesome, he has a beard and long hair and stuff like that.
Oh, yeah.
I can't watch those. It's like two or three episodes that I can't watch in that season. I'm like, I don't like them.
Okay, you know what's weird is that I remember you talking about this the last time saying that, and when they showed, like, the seasons all over again, and I saw the governor again, I couldn't take him after a while. I couldn't stand him either.
I just think that they could have given him more. Like, the way Negan is, I feel like that... The governor could have been something similar to that. Maybe tone down just a little bit, make him seem a little bit more human, you know. But Negan's like top level villain. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I think governor could have been a little bit more interesting to me. Mojo Hippie says, "I want to see the world saved before the show is canceled, or like you know, I guess before the show ends." I would, I guess, kind of like to see a happy ending.
You know what? I don't like care. I don't care what Mojo Hippie has to say, because that's the guy that picked the number.
He's holding it against you, Mojo. He's the one that picked the number that got him the hot pepper.
I remember.
Or not the hot pepper. Was it the hot pepper or was it the Oreo
habanero,
one?
The habanero.
Was it? Oh. Yeah. Yeah, so. I don't care what Mojo. I got you, man. You're on my side, dude.
I think that shows, like, it's like it's doomed for tragedy. You know, it's like.
Now, it would make it a lot more interesting if they left it as, like, a bad ending, like a terrible ending that happened. Like, maybe Rick dies.
Everybody's looking at each other and it just ends.
Yeah. They pull the Sopranos. They go to a diner and they don't Journey. Stop. And then it just fades to black, is it? Yeah, no, it would be terrible if they didn't give it a proper ending. I could appreciate a good happy ending at the end of it, though.
They're going to do some, like, I Am Legend ending where the human race is repopulating and then they're just going to, like, narrate it. Everything's being better now and blah, blah, blah. And then...
They show clips of people, like, planting flowers.
Yeah, like flowers are going to fucking save the world and shit. You know?
I just hope that they don't give one of those endings that like, whoa, it's your own, you know, interpretation. You know, make of it what you will. I hope they don't do that. I hope they give a clear-cut ending and that's it. And who knows when that's even going to happen. Apparently, they're planning for, like, they're going to be at season 7. I mean, this thing could go for, like, at least 15 seasons.
Oh, wait.
I would say.
Man, I only have three?
Originally, I predicted, like, season 10. But they're at 7, and they're still going strong, man. I think it could go at least 15. Imagine that box set.
Yeah.
Like, fucking huge.
You're going to, like, it's going to be so many damn seasons, you're going to, like, be able to make a zombie. You already got the zombie head.
Yeah, I got one.
You're going to come with a chest cavity and an arm.
The limited edition Blu-ray for this season that's coming out, I think it's coming out in November.
Uh-huh.
And it's the zombie that's stuck between the two trailers, 18-wheeler trailers.
Oh, and his
skin. Yeah, and pulls it away.
Uh-huh.
So you could probably, like, pull him through and pull him back or something. I don't know. But that looks pretty cool. And McFarlane Toys does them.
Oh, really?
Does them all. They do all the limited edition sets.
Oh.
That's a McFarlane.
Really?
Zombie head.
I thought he only did the one with the heads.
Oh, he does all of them. He did all of them so far. But yeah, so I don't know. I mean, I thought the Negan speech, the uncensored one, was so effective, uncensored with all the F-bombs. And I thought it was just going to be like, oh, well, you know, it's word for word from the comic.
Yeah.
But when you read the comic, some of it sounds kind of silly when he's dropping the F-word. It just looks like he's saying the F-word just to say the F-word.
Yeah.
You know? And this dude, Jeffrey Dean Morgan, he recited it word for word from the comics, and it worked. Like, it worked so good, you know? The way he smiles as he's telling these people they're gonna one of them's gonna die.
Yeah.
It's so, like, nefarious, dude. Like,
it is, man.
Like, oh my god, you have no heart.
Yeah. None of y'all jump out
now
because I will fucking kill you.
Oh, yeah, I'll shut that shit down.
I'll shut that shit down.
Now they did reveal. We're going off topic just a little bit, but they did reveal where Lucille came from. His bat.
Yeah.
And it turns out that was the name of his wife.
Oh, really?
His wife died. She had cancer right before the apocalypse.
Didn't you say there was like
like a little comic.
Clip.
That's what they're doing. Every month they're doing like 4 pages at a time.
Hmm.
And I think at the end of it, they're probably going to release like a full, you know, book.
They still, I noticed on Big Bad Toy Store, that they still have a couple of the replicas of Lucille Bat.
Really?
Yeah. And they're not expensive at all. I think they're like 40 something.
Oh, that's not bad.
I know. You know, I'm sure.
I want to get that 2-pack, man.
What 2-pack?
They have the 2-pack on there, too. I didn't see the bat, but they have the Negan and Glenn 2-pack.
Oh, yeah. They even have the colored, and then they have the black and white. Yeah.
I want to get at least one of those.
The colored one look cooler to me.
Yeah. But, man, so Negan, I mean, Negan is just like, he's gearing up to be like the freaking villain of the show. I would say not even of the season. I would say of the show, period. You know, this guy, people have been waiting for this guy
yeah.
forever. And watching the show again from the very beginning to the end, it felt better watching it like one right after another.
Yeah.
You know, without the wait, because you see from the very beginning where, you know, the motorcycle gang or whatever, like, you know, your property belongs to Negan. And then they, you know, sprinkle Negan and his name throughout the whole season until that very last moment. And you're like, what? Even seeing it again, I was like, man, this is so cool.
Hell yeah.
You know, so Negan, man, Negan's like he's the villain of the show.
So
the
we
villain
got
of The Walking Dead.
About a month left or so, right?
Yeah, I think, yeah.
We're in September, right?
September. So yeah, we're at the end of October.
It's right around the corner, man.
Right around the corner. And it's going to be so worth it. It's going to be so worth the wait. And just like Jeffrey Dean Morgan said, like, you know, that people keep asking him, you know, what's the, you know, who got killed? You know, who's the one that gets it? And no, he's like, you know what? He's like, you'll see. Just wait and find out. You know? He's like, and then if you're so, you know, anxious that you want to see spoilers, he's like, you're going to see something. He's like, if you come across something that's legit, you're going to wish you didn't. He's like, and people that are so, you know, like, I want to see the show. You're going to wish that season 7 never happened.
Yeah.
You know? Because you're going to see who died and you're going to just be sad. Yeah. You know? And everybody keeps giving that same answer. I'm sure they probably don't give that answer.
Yeah.
But I said that from the very beginning. Right before they showed the last episode, I'm like, This is going to be terrible. I want to see it, but I don't want to see it.
You know what? And for a good while, we were doing that. We were trying to find out. David sent me some messages or something like that. And before I even opened that, I remember that running through my mind was, do I really want to know? And then
I watched it.
I was like, oh, I knew it. But then finding out later on, oh, it was all hooey and shit. And I was like, oh. All right, you know what? I'm happy it is. Because now I don't want to know.
Yeah. I mean, I was happy with the cliffhanger. It was one of those cliffhangers that were like, ah, you know? But
yeah.
I wasn't mad that it happened. I'm just like, ah, I guess I got to wait, you know?
Damn it.
But it was good, though. I mean, great episode, great season. You know, but what can you do? Season 7's right around the corner. The wait is worth it. It's worth it. So with that being said, we're going to go ahead and end this episode of the Bot Squad podcast. Damn it. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you guys for tuning in on Twitch. You guys are amazing. Mojo Hippie, Fluffy Butt.
Fluffy Butt?
I think it's Fluffy Butt. Fluffy Butt. Blu-ray Dan. Thank you guys, man. Thank you guys for tuning in. I really appreciate it. And everybody else on Periscope, all that stuff. Y'all are amazing. Check out CinemaDeviant.com for all your movies, news, reviews, trailers. Go and like Facebook page at Facebook.com/CinemaDeviant. Instagram, CinemaDeviant. Snapchat, CinemaDeviant. Tumblr, I love you, Tumblr. Tumblr.com/CinemaDeviant. And I think that's it. What are your social medias? Oh, Twitter. Cinema Deviant.
There you go.
There you go.
What are you doing? You got one more.
go for it.
Instagram, BobBang94. Twitter and Snapchat is Spawn94AEW. Both of them, Spawn94AEW. Another thing, too, is that I have another t-shirt giveaway, I guess. I'll show you.
Okay. Show you. Well, maybe we could do, like, another Facebook live stream.
There you go.
And we'll announce the giveaway.
And it's another t-shirt and everything, and it's awesome one, man. It's a really, really cool one. What did they call it? Ripped
Apparel.
Yeah, this one, these guys, they're pretty cool. You'll see. So just, you know, stay tuned and everything.
Stay tuned. Like the Facebook page, mm-hmm. facebook.com/BotSquadPodcast, mm-hmm. and we'll be going live on Facebook to announce the, mm-hmm. the giveaway there.
And like our previous winner, he won the Spawn workout t-shirt. It was the Julian Espinoza.
Yes.
His package has been sent out and everything, and the dude's like psyched. He's just crazy.
It was for his dad, I think,
for
right?
For his dad, yeah. And
that's awesome. That's even better, man.
Even the shirt before that, it was Chad M. Michael.
Chad Michael Murray.
Yeah. That guy was it worked out so perfect for him, you know, because he wanted the damn t-shirt so bad and everything, and he won. So, again, yeah, just like how David said, like us, you know?
Yeah. So, and then, Sid, I think that's it, right? Facebook.com/BotSquadPodcast. Like I said, like that page there. Mm-hmm. And I think that's pretty much it. We got everything right. Mm-hmm. Closing ceremonies here. Mm-hmm. Catch you next.